Hello everyone, in our today's video, we are going to study internal genital of a female reproductive system. The internal genital of a female reproductive system consists of a pair of ovaries, a pair of fallopian tube, a uterus or womb, cervix and a vagina. So related with the female reproductive system, just take a glance of this diagram. In this, you can see a pair of ovaries, a pair of fallopian tubes, or it is also called as a oviduct, a uterus, or it is called as a womb, then the cervix, then vagina, and externally having a vulva. Okay, so related with the female reproductive system, in this, the internal genitalia, which consists of a pair of ovaries. So related with the ovaries. Ovaries are called as a primary sex organ of a female, or called as a primary gonads of a female. Okay, its origin is mesodermal origin. Okay, its origin is mesodermal origin. It is located in a ovarian fossa of a pelvic region. It is present in a ovarian fossa of a pelvic region. Its shape is almond shape and its weight is about 2.8 grams. Its dimensions are near about 3 into 2 into 1 centimeter length, width and thickness. 3 centimeter length, 2 centimeter width and 1 centimeter thickness. So related with ovaries, ovaries are present on either side of the uterus, attached to uterine wall and mesentery. Okay, it is also attached to this pelvic cavity also by an mesobarium. Okay, so this is related with the pair of ovaries. These ovaries are primary gonads of a female and these are responsible for production of ova. When female comes at maturity at that time, it starts producing ova, as well as female sex hormone, estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen and progesterone are formed, right, from the ovaries. Then the next part is the fallopian tubes. These fallopian tubes are also called as oviduct. Its length is about 10 to 12 centimeters. Its length is about 10 to 12 centimeters and present on the either side of the uterus, right? It consists of fimbri, a finger-like projection, then a infundibulum, then ampulla and the isthmus. The fimbri is very close to the ovaries and the fimbri having large size ciliated epithelial cells. Then the next one is the infundibulum and ampulla. The ampulla is a site of fertilization. This oviduct and the isthmus, the fallopian tube opens into the uterus by the isthmus, or it is the end portion of the oviduct at where it opens into the uterus, right? This fallopian tube or the oviduct is internally lined by ciliated epithelia. This ciliated epithelia plays a very vital role to push or to sweep the ova or the fertilized ovum or whatever the cleavage stage that or the embryo towards the uterus, right? In a fallopian tube, there is a presence of non-ciliated cells. These non-ciliated cells are called as a PEG cells. Okay, these PEG cells provide nourishment. That means this fallopian tube is internally lined by two types of cells. One is ciliated epithelial cell and the another one is a non-ciliated epithelial cells. Ciliated epithelial cells just swept the ova or fertilized ovum or the whatever the embryo towards the womb. Okay, then the non-ciliated cells which are present in a fallopian tube plays a very vital role which provide nourishment to the ova. Nourishment towards to the ova. So the function of the fallopian tube is just the function of the fallopian tube is a maturation and transport of the ovum, and it is a site for fertilization. Here the ampulla is a site of fertilization. The next part is the uterus. Uterus is also called as a womb. Uterus is also called as a womb. So related with this uterus. Uterus is large, hollow, muscular, pear-shaped sac-like structure. It is highly muscular, pear-shaped, hollow, muscular sac-like structure. Its dimensions are 8 into 5 into 2 centimeters. That means its length is about 8 centimeter, thickness is about 5 width is about 5 centimeters and thickness is about 2 centimeters. It is made up of 3 layers. It is highly muscular. It is made up of 3 layers. The outermost is called as perimetrium. Middle one is called as myometrium, and the inner one is called as the endometrium. These 3 layers are forming the wall of the uterus. Then the next one, the function of the uterus is, it is highly glandular, it is highly muscular and highly glandular, and its main function is, it is a site for implantation. It is a site for implantation. Then the next one is the cervix. Next region is the cervix. Its length is about 2.5 centimeters. The length of cervix is about 2.5 centimeters. Cervix is the most titanous feature in the body of a human. And it is lined by, when the cervix opens into the vagina, the opening is the external US. And cervix opens into the uterus, and that opening is the internal OS. During the pregnancy period, this internal and external OS get closed by a mucus plug. The main function of the cervix, it is the most titanous feature in the body of a human female. Then the next one, the cervix opens into the vagina. The vagina is internally lined by a vaginal rugi. These are the small folds which are present in the vagina. It is used during the act of coitus. It stimulates the or exerts a pressure on a penis and make it erect, keeps the penis erect into during the act of coitus or intercourse. Its length is near about 8 centimeters. The length of vagina is near about 8 centimeters, and vagina externally opens into the vulva. It externally opens into the vulva, and the function of vagina. Vagina is a passage for menstrual flow. It is a passage for a baby during normal delivery. That means it is also called as a birth canal, and it is the path to receive the male penis during the act of coitus. So this is all related with the internal genital of a female. Thank you very much.